parte per la rete. All right, I know your live shows. You do, lui fa tantissimo per fare questi i suoi live. Diceva prima che erano stati molto grandi. Anche quest'anno, anche questo giro. Do you think you're going to try and scale down the lives?
Well, what I did already is that I did an acoustic tour around Europe and around the States and stuff, where I played very small venues and theatres and churches and stuff like that. And in Milan, actually, a couple of weeks ago, we did the Franco Parenti Theatre, which was really, really fun because it was basically all about the music again. It was so focused. And I wanted people to hear the songs the way that I write them, because I write at the piano and I wanted people to be able to hear that. I was always a little bit worried, though, that if it was just a piano and a couple musicians without a full show, that I wouldn't get the same response, because in the past I always do really, really big productions.
Elaborate, yeah.
Yeah. But actually, it was almost even more effective. I mean, we did a show in Berlin and it was in a church, and it was the first time in the history of this church that people actually stood on top of all the chairs and benches and were raving up and down in this church, which is good, because if it happened too often, they'd probably ban concerts there.
Allora, mi ha raccontato una storia bellissima di un concerto fatto in una chiesa a Berlino dove tutte le persone saltavano sulle sedie, e ha detto meno male che non succede spesso, perché sennò non ci fanno fare i concerti all'interno delle chiese. E sicuramente lui ha fatto, insomma, dei concerti molto più minimalizzati. Dopo gli stadi ha voluto tornare nei teatri e farci ascoltare la musica come lui la scrive. Lui la scrive con una tastiera, pianoforte, anche strumenti acustici. È un modo molto intimo di vivere la musica, e lui ha voluto portare il suo live così. And your next plans, Mika, seeing as you're not very good on holidays. Non è molto bravo a fare le vacanze. L'ultima volta doveva fare un mese, ha fatto solo 4 giorni.
Well, actually, I'm taking one holiday around my birthday, and I think I'm going to end up maybe on the Amalfi Coast, and I'm renting a big house and inviting all my friends and family from around the world. So I've got that 7-day break and I'm going to take advantage of it.
Fantastico. Allora, per il suo compleanno avrà 7 giorni di festa. Ha deciso di prendere una grande villa nella costa di Amalfi, invitare tutti gli amici, tutti i parenti, passare una settimana con lui. Can we come? Possiamo venire anche noi?
Sure. And you know what? But apart from that, that's probably going to be my 1 7-day holiday until, I think, Christmas time. So I've got to make the most of it. But up until then I'm going to be doing some more shows. I am doing quite a few really big TV shows in Italy. Which I don't know if I'm supposed to announce, but I'm not allowed to announce them apparently. But they're really big and we're planning some really fun stuff for
around
all that.
September.
And
then I can work out what TV
and
show
October.
It is.
And so we're doing lots of things like that, and then the album comes out in September.
Yes.
And the single comes out in September too. But I'm really looking forward to doing a bigger tour. And I'm playing Rome, actually, in the new year, which I've never done.
Yes, so, I know that.
So it should be kind of cool.
We're waiting
so we'll
for
see.
You.
Ah, oh, wicked.
Ok, allora Mika finalmente, un'ottima notizia, verrà a Roma all'inizio dell'anno, e questa è una cosa importante perché lui live a Roma ancora non è venuto. We'll keep our listeners updated so that, you know, that they all come running down. E sicuramente, insomma, molto lavoro per lui. A settembre esce l'album, a settembre esce il singolo che abbiamo ascoltato, We Are Golden, which is really actually brilliant. We love it.
Fantastic.
Like I told
Thank you
at the beginning. Come ho detto all'inizio, è una canzone che ci dà un sacco di allegria, che ci serviva. Do you notice how your voice changes as well when you speak different languages?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Why
is that? Stavo chiedendo al volo, come mai li cambia la voce?
Always. But you know what?
Yeah.
Because it just kind of, you adapt to different things in your ears, and you're not really tied to any particular accent because you never grew up in one place for too long. That's what I've kind of noticed, you know?
That's probably
Have you noticed that?
Yeah, I do feel like a third culture kid.
There you go.
Are you
there
a third you culture kid? That's what I am. Like, it's like heaps of, you know, different places to call home, but I wouldn't know how to choose one.
Exactly. And I was once I was thrown out of a very posh dinner party that was in Spain, because there was this old man who was sitting there going, he was kind of nationalistic, and he was like, you think, you don't come from anywhere, what are you supposed to go home, you know, I fought in the army and I did all this and I'm so proud of everything. And I said, well, actually, I'm quite glad not to have the shackles of patriotism that have obviously taken away the objectivity of your perspective on so many things. And I think that's kind of true. You just kind of can look at things from an outsider all the time. And I think that if you are, at least for being a musician, that's only a good thing. And when you're on the road all the time, you get more comfortable with being this kind of traveling gypsy, which is essentially what you are. And it's great. It's amazing. I love it.
I might just translate that because that was really nice. Allora, Mika, abbiamo parlato del fatto che in comune abbiamo il fatto che abbiamo girato il mondo, che ci sono tanti paesi che chiamiamo casa, ma non sapremo scegliere un paese da dire questo è il paese di cui io ho la mia patria. E ha fatto una discussione in un locale con un signore anziano che diceva: ma tu cosa ne sai? Che sei cresciuto in tanti posti, non hai un posto da chiamare casa. E Mika dice che lui in un certo senso si sente anche sollevato dal fatto che non è così patriottico, che è un po' come uno zingaro che gira intorno per il mondo, e più gira e più si sente libero senza un'etichetta di una nazionalità addosso. All right, Mika, thank you so much, and we hope to see you here soon, and all the best with everything. You're lovely to have a chat to.
Ah, thank you so much.
Grazie, Mika. Ciao.